In psychological research, great pains are taken to avoid a confirmation bias. Confirmation bias is when someone has a hypothesis, they only look for evidence that would support their hypothesis. They don't look for evidence that would disprove it. So in psychological research, we want to avoid confirmation bias. Now, we may have a hypothesis, for example, that our drug relieves mental illness. And if that's the case, it's very important to be looking for evidence, not just for, but against, because we want to avoid confirmation bias. So if this is what we really want to prove, we will be expected as a good scientist and psychologist to instead try to disprove. So even though this is what we're interested in studying, we are going to say, my real hypothesis is that our drug has no effect on illness. The reason we do this, we play this game, we really mean to prove this, but we're going to state that we're trying to prove this, is because it is so important to avoid confirmation bias and to assume, in the absence of evidence, that we probably don't have a real effect. This hypothesis is called the null, N-U-L-L, and usually the textbook will call it H sub O. And the null hypothesis says our drug has no effect. This is the hypothesis we're testing in research so as to avoid having a confirmation bias. There's also an alternative hypothesis. And usually the textbook calls this H sub A. And that is that our drug does have an effect. So we have some backward language here. We're testing the null and saying our drug has no effect. And we're hoping to reject the null. So we are adopting the null hypothesis for now, but we are hoping to ultimately reject it because our data actually shows through our statistical test that probably there is an effect. So, when we say reject the null, what we really mean is claim an effect. Claim that our study worked. We win. We found something we might get to publish. Rejecting the null is a good thing. It's just jargon for saying it's not the null. I get to reject this null hypothesis, which I was entertaining in order to avoid having a confirmation bias.